a toy shop of its own kind at Riley Hospital for Children. I got an exclusive look inside the Riley Guild Cheer Toy Room. Take a look.
It's a critical time inside Riley's Cheer Guild Toy Room. These volunteers, more like elves, sorting and organizing hundreds of donated items.
It really makes Christmas. Christmas.
But their effort doesn't stop after the holidays.
I still have to fight back the tears.
This toy room looks like Santa's workshop year-round.
That toy is not just a toy. These items are used to help teach kids about what's happening to them while they're here at the hospital.
Right now.
Hey there, Brianna.
Hundreds of kids, like 6-year-old Brianna, are at Riley Hospital receiving treatment.
This is an animal Shopkins. Have you ever seen these before?
Some for life-threatening illnesses.
Do you have big, strong muscles?
For them, these toys feel like a lifeline.
A couple of years ago, someone came running through the office and said, "There's an emergency." I thought, okay, we're gonna take care of this. We are out of Uno cards. Oh, okay, it's a different kind of emergency.
The toys aren't just used for play.
Have you ever done this one before?
As a distraction. But child life specialists use these donated items to teach kids about the diseases they're fighting and the procedures they'll have to endure.
Pretty scary procedures. And so I come in there, I bring maybe their favorite Paw Patrol toy and talk to them about it.
Child life specialists visit this toy room every day, skipping the naughty or nice list and shopping here for what they think their patients need most.
We couldn't really do our job without it.
Families, like the Garners, are desperate to be home for the holidays, but thankful for the Hoosier hospitality.
When they come in and they make them feel special, giving them, you know, stuff that really, you know, we wouldn't be able to afford because of being off, you know, and it's awesome.
They are celebrating the true meaning of Christmas and planning to pay it forward the minute they can.
Once she's done and out of here, we plan on donating also because of, we know the good mental aspects that can come out of it.
And those kids able to keep going because they have those small but really special moments to look forward to, like the toys. For perspective, Riley gave out more than 200,000 toys last year alone. And they're constantly using social media, by the way, to restock some of their most requested items. The most recent, a Play-Doh shortage. So here's what they're looking for right now. Toys specifically for babies and toddlers under the age of 3. Die-cast cars, art packs, journals, Legos, a lot of Legos, board games, and puzzles. If you'd like to donate, I'll post a link on my social media and then also online at cbs4indy.com. 557 and